Well, last night on Bachelor in Paradise, Laurina left everyone in shock after storming off the island and the show. Here's how it all unfolded when she was given a last-minute date card.
All right, can I talk to someone about this?
I am not even thinking about going on a date. I'm literally, like, in the zen zone, ready to sort of be getting into bed soon.
Well, that just made me really uncomfortable.
But it's a good thing you're
taking No, it's not. Because I don't like anybody here.
What do you mean?
And I don't like feeling uncomfortable all the time, being on this, like, you know, like, if it happens naturally and I, you know, gravitate towards someone,
yeah.
And then you come and say, oh, go get here, you're 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Like,
this date card's come through. I'm not really prepared for it. I'm just about to go to bed. I haven't had a shower. I didn't appreciate being sprung on me.
I don't need a date.
I didn't realise that you're not interested in anyone here.
I'm not.
But you know, that's what these dates are designed for, is for you guys to go and try and find a connection with someone.
Why would you do that? Why would you just spring it on me in 10 minutes? Why wouldn't you say, hey, Laurina, would you like to do a date tonight? You know, we'll give you some notice. So it's a pretty uncomfortable position that you put me in. Be a bit more considerate.
Well,
this is not cool. I'm gonna leave.
And here to explain it all is Laurina herself. She joins us now live from Perth. Laurina, welcome to Studio 10.
Hi.
You went into Bachelor in Paradise looking for love, so why did you decide to leave?
I suppose I've got a bit of explaining to do. So I went into Paradise hoping to have an amazing time and laugh and meet beautiful people and, you know, enjoy a bit of a holiday. But a month before I went in, I actually lost my brother to suicide, and I guess there was a bit of escapism going on, and I was doing my best to sort of do as much healing as I could, but I didn't realise just how probably emotionally unstable that I actually was until I got a little bit upset and that opened up the floodgates, and next minute I was next to hysterical.
But it's only natural.
And I guess I realised.
It's only natural that you should feel like that.
Yeah.
And are you getting some support now?
Yeah, look, that was a little while ago, and it was so soon. It was probably too soon to go, but, you know, I didn't. I was, you know, hoping to escape. And it was a wonderful bit of healing as well.
Are you serious?
So did it all sort of, I guess, catch up with you and hit you when you were there on the island, Laurina? Is that sort of what happened?
Honestly, it was just that moment. I wasn't even aware that that was what was going to happen. Like, it took me by just as much surprise as it did everybody else. And that was when I realised, like, I've got to listen to my body, and I'm anxious, and I'm, you know, I'm not emotionally well right now. I'm hysterical over no reason. And that was pretty obvious that it was time to go home. And
so it wasn't actually. I suppose a lot of people watching would have thought, well, hang on, this is a dating show. Why wouldn't she want to go on a date? But in fact, you're saying it actually had nothing to do with the date at all. It was just all this other stuff suddenly coming to the fore.
Well, it was that as well. I didn't really want to go on a date. You know, I was told there was going to be someone there that I would fall madly in love with, and that they would be new, not from old bachelors. So I guess once we had had the new boys come in and I thought, oh, I'm not into any of those and I'm not into anyone here, I sort of became pretty much aware that there wasn't really going to be someone that I was going to be interested in. So I guess that day and that night sort of just all came to a head, and, yeah, I had a wonderful time, but it was a good time, not a long time.
I think you'll find that the memory of your brother will come back again and again. I've lost one brother. He died from bowel cancer. And, you know, when you least expect it, he sort of pops into your mind. And I don't know whether it's their way of reminding us of the time we had together. I think it is a bit. But I said to my brother before he died, you'll always live in my heart. And that's how I remember him. And I found that helped me.
How are you? Yeah, I've actually spoken to... I didn't even speak to a medium. One of my brother's friends spoke to a medium, and she bought me 2 pages of messages from my brother that were like my innermost thoughts and feelings and fears and things that, you know, I didn't even know my brother knew them. And to have that presented to me on a piece of paper was like 2 pieces of paper was It was nice. Laurina, it was really comforting.
You have been to hell and back. What was that like being on an island so far away from your family at such a difficult time for your family?
To be honest, it was wonderful. I really, really took the best out of that situation. I was, you know, it was nice being out of reality and, you know, on a tropical island and you're surrounded by love and laughter and tropical environment, and I could just go and relax. You know, production were really gentle with me. They let me do my own thing most of the time, and I'd come in and, because I wasn't drinking either, I think it's really important to stay sober when you're healing. And I couldn't keep up with the others drinking all day. So I'd come out in little bursts and have a play and then go back and, you know, take some little time for myself. And they were really gentle with me. Everyone was really supportive. It was really actually a very nice thing to do.
Well, Laurina, of course, everyone here on the panel is sending so much love to you and to your family.
Thank you so much.
And, of course, if you have a friend or a family member who's going through a hard time, you can always call Lifeline. That number is 131114. And don't forget to tune in to Bachelor in Paradise tonight at 7:30 on both the Ten and Win networks. Laurina, lots of love to you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Laurina.
Thanks, Laurina.